Hello, peoples. Hey, so I thought I would jump on and give you guys some ideas because I get this question all the time and I'm finagling it because I'm getting ready to jump into the gym for one of my strength workouts. But I wanted to get on real quick because I happen to have my handy dandy emergency snack kit. It's really fancy schmancy. So are you ready? Super fancy. But I think you could probably figure out how to get one. Maybe. I think you could get your hand on it. Just kidding. It's so easy. So it's literally, this is almost always in my car. It's just a blender bottle, whatever shaker cup you want to use. And then I shove in it a protein. We'll come back to that in a second in terms of like what to use. And I also literally, I'm literally pulling it out of my shaker cup. I shove in a small apple. Ta-da! And a handful of nuts. Take note though, nuts, this is like a serving of nuts. So a handful of nuts is not like a big old grip full of nuts. Nuts are awesome, but they're also high in calories, high in fat, which is not a bad fat. Almonds, Brazil nuts, walnuts, cashews, really just about anything other than peanuts are great healthy nuts to have. But you just want to make sure that like anything else, you're doing it in moderation. So again, this is my emergency kit. Almost every day I have one of these in my car. It's a blender bottle with no water in it. I just literally pack in my handful of nuts, a small apple, and some sort of protein. So the protein does make a difference. So it depends. Like right now, this is just regular straight protein because I'm gonna go do a lift workout. And so I want quality protein right after I'm done lifting. But 9 times out of 10, when this is the emergency kit that is just sitting in my car, it's my meal replacement shake. So that if I do get sick and I'm not packed a cooler or what have you, and I need something, that I've got something clean, quick, easy, that's going to give me a protein, carb, fat balance. You have to be careful with what you can get at, like, say, fast food or what have you. Not even fast food, but what was I trying to say? Convenience stores. Because a lot of times when we pick up protein bars or something quick at a convenience store, those are full of junk, sugar, additives. And really, most of the protein bars that you can get at like an AMPM or Quick Mart or whatever your local gas station is called is actually just a candy bar, and they've thrown in some protein in it so they can call it a protein bar. So a lot of times this shaker cup has just a dry packet of either my meal replacement, or like I said, this time it's just straight protein because of the fact that I'm going to use it right after I'm done working out. What kind of protein? That's a whole nother video, because a lot of the protein that we buy over the counter is full of junk and fillers as well. So you've got to make sure that you source your protein and make sure that you're putting quality ingredients into your body. Another quick go-to source is I use Isagenix, so I always have their bar. I actually literally just pulled that out of my wallet. Thankfully my car is clean today, so I can show you a little bit. But this is literally just stuff I keep on hand in case I'm stuck. There are a couple of things that you can get at a grocery store if you don't have this packed, but literally pretty much on a daily basis I pack this emergency kit just in case. Even if I think I'm gonna be home in time for my next meal or what have you, you just never know when you're, you know, busy on the go, as we are for like most of us, right? Life is crazy. You gotta learn to expect the unexpected. I'm putting my emergency kit back together. But if you are stuck out and about, I'm visual, so I'm trying to think. There are jerkies that you can get. So some of the jerkies are okay and some of them aren't. And I'm saying jerky because they have turkey jerky, they have bacon jerky. And the one that I found has the least amount of sugar is the Oberto's, and it's their bacon jerky. Some of those jerkies, again, you got to be careful. You don't have to be an expert. Just start looking at labels. Just start eyeballing labels. And if you see sugar or cane sugar or brown sugar syrup or anything like that on like the second or third ingredient, then it's really not something that you want to be having if you're looking at trying to get closer to your goals. If you know that you're having a treat, that's fine. The difference is knowledge is power, so know what it is that you're putting in your body. So those Oberto jerkies, the one that is the bacon jerky, is actually pretty good, and it is, I think, 1 gram of sugar for serving. There's also little individual packets in the nut section that is the men's health keep getting calls coming in. Either they're heart healthy or there's one other kind on there too, that those are pretty good. So the next time I stop in there, I'll pick them up and I'll show you. And I'll also show you examples of how something as simple as granola or one of those health mixes that should be, or they're trying to pawn themselves off as being healthy, are loaded with sugar and junk that you just don't want to get. So in a perfect world, you're packing your food. That doesn't always happen. So now you're having your emergency backup. All right. And then when all else fails, you are
disconnected. New connect phone.
I'm ready. In my car. I'm not driving. I'm sitting in the parking lot. So when all else fails, you are doing your emergency kit, or you can, there's a couple things you can get. That's the other thing that I packed for yesterday on the Harley ride. If it helps you guys, I knew I was going to be gone all day, but I wasn't going to be in a place where I could bring a cooler. I'm on a Harley. So I literally packed my emergency kit just like this, with a couple of different meal replacement shakes, as well as there are a couple of different packets of meal replacement, protein, apple, a couple bags of mixed nuts. And then when we were at the event, there was no good options, like, whatsoever. So yes, for the first time in probably, I don't know, well, probably 4 years since I've had kielbasa, but I had one of those like massive, huge kielbasa links. But it was, and I just did no bun, had the kielbasa with ketchup, and then had my apple and my nuts, and I was good to go. So you can choose to eat healthy when you're trying to get closer to an ideal healthy lifestyle or fitness goals, all right? So any questions, post them up below, and I promise my commitment to you is to get back on track with these videos, and I will make sure that I do at least 3 a week, either on food tips or motivations or workouts. I'm going to get back on track with you guys because I feel like I've been falling short lately. So let me know what I can answer for you, and I'm happy to. See you guys soon. Bye.